For us, it's a combination from CeMAT and Hannover Messe. We are on the CeMAT, and we like to present on the CeMAT Next Fleet. And Next Fleet is a fleet management software, and it's combined with our trucks. I think it's not only important to produce trucks, it's very important that we have services and that we have software with trucks, because customers like to have a solution, not only a truck. It's very important for us that we combine material information flow, and we live in a world of Industry 4.0. It means for us Logistics 4.0 and for us especially Intralogistics 4.0. And it means that we combine forklift trucks with software, with information tags and so on. And as an innovation, there we have an autonomous truck, and therefore I have a specialist, it's Paul Eberhard. He can say something about this autonomous truck.
We have introduced the Aigoneo CX20, which is the first autonomous forklift truck worldwide, actually. And it's about what is the difference between autonomy and automation. So autonomy means that the forklift truck is able to find its way through the factory the optimal way, the most efficient way. And autonomy also means for us working together of people and machines. And so the Aigoneo aids the workers by driving autonomously and finding the way. So the worker doesn't have to find the way for the vehicle anymore. Instead, the vehicle drives by itself and finds the solution by itself, so it decides by itself. And in the end, this means an efficiency increase up to 30%. The Aigoneo has like two laser sensors on top, which you can see also, they are like the eyes of the machine. And what the machine does is permanently scanning the environment. It's up to 30 meters of radius. So what it does, it's like 6,000 views per second, scanning everything around it. And it also scans the workers in the factory. And it scans, of course, also the boxes or anything in the way of the vehicle. So what it does is taking all the information it gets, visual information, processes it, and then it has a digital map of the factory. And afterwards, it's driving the perfect way to help the worker. This means the worker doesn't have to steer anymore. He doesn't have to step on and off the vehicle, and everything he can do is what he does best, and that's picking. Because any robot on the world right now isn't as fast as a human. Humans are 4 seconds from seeing the box, taking it, putting it on the vehicle. Robots need four minutes. That's why we see a very important position of our workers still. And we try to help the workers do their job that they can do the best. Of course, we develop more efficient solutions, and we will, of course, we have more automation, we have autonomy. We see this in any aspect, in any area. We also see this, of course, for cars and so on. And of course also for the factory, the so-called smart factory. But this process will be slow. It won't be from today and tomorrow there are only smart factories. That's why we have right now, of course, people in the factories which play a very important role. And in the future, like 40, 50 years, they will be more totally smart factories, like in general smart factories, no people involved maybe. But it's very, very important that we get more efficient because of the demographic change. We have less people, and less people have to be the same effect, have to have the same effectiveness that we had before. So there is a need for Industry 4.0, and we try to help our customers getting more and more Industry 4.0.
Please visit Still on the Pavilion 35. There you can see a lot of innovations and a lot of informations about Industry 4.0 and Intralogistics 4.0.